Happy Tuesday, guys. It is Toastmaster Tuesday. I have been on my laptop today reading the Toastmasters magazine from my laptop. I get a book through the mail, but for some reason, it's not come yet. So I have access to it, though, on the website, on their website, on my members' thing. So I am going to be, I'm going to go over what I put on the title here in just a minute. But I just kind of wanted to let everybody know what today is Tuesday, which we have our Toastmasters meeting tonight. I will be the all-counter grammarian. And that is exactly what it means. I will count the us and the ands and the buts. The grammarian will listen for filler words, so, but, repetitive words. And it's not that you're going to get shot for doing it. It just really makes you aware of how much we use those filler words. And it's okay in everyday conversations, if you're conversating with somebody, you know, just on the phone or a friendly conversation. But when you come before a group of people, you don't want a lot of filler words and a lot of ands and uhs, and like you're searching and reaching for those, the next word. But I found this in the magazine, and I think it's awesome. Oh, yeah. Also, the all-counter grammarian also brings the word for the day. So that, I have already got the word, and I've got it printed out. And I'm going to bring that with me tonight. And what we do with that is we will try our best to use that word as many times as we can during the meeting. It's just another challenge. It's another practice to get you to think outside the box, so to speak. But on here online, it says practice your ABCs, which is an acronym for always be curious. Practice your ABCs, always be curious. This is in the magazine of the Toastmasters magazine in one of their articles. Great leaders. Now, this falls to me in any leadership, whether you're leading in the church world, whether you're leading in the secular world, it still applies there. Great leaders are intensely curious and make continual learning a high priority. They ask questions, seek expert advice, read intensively, and invest in training. So they're always investing in themselves. Even today, before I found this, I try my best on Tuesdays. Each day I try to focus. And I've just started this the last few months. Each day of the week, I try to focus on one thing. Today is Toastmasters Day. So I get on my laptop, or I usually get my magazine out. I review the magazine. I review the articles. I read the education things. I look at what's coming up. I look at their contest. I also, like if I'm going to speak, I will work on my speech that day. So today is Toastmaster Tuesday, and I try my best not to waste no day. I don't ever want to waste. I'm at an age in my life. Every day counts right now for all of us. I want to make sure that I'm being productive in those days. But I also want to let everybody know that wants to come, that Toastmasters meeting group is in Jonesboro at the college at 6:00 every Tuesday night. You can come as a guest for like 3 times. And no one pressures you. I was not pressured. I went with the intention of planning on joining that club because I wanted to advance in my speaking skills. But it's fun. It's just fun to sit in on one of the meetings and listen to the speeches and the evaluations. And we have good laughs. And it's just a good, fun time. But I'm going to get off of here for the Toastmaster Tuesday. And if anyone's ever interested in that, you're welcome to message me. I'll give you the information. I'll give you the time. I'll give you the address. And guests are always welcome. Guests are always welcome. And matter of fact, they really want you to. They want the guests to come so they can kind of, you know, see what's going on. So until next Tuesday, y'all have a great day. And this has been your tip from Toastmaster Tuesday for today. Practice your ABCs. Always be curious.